Hi, I'm Arthur.
I'm Vivian.
And I'm Candace, and welcome to What's New with Microsoft 365 in August.
This month, we have updates including new features for Whiteboard in Microsoft Teams and on the web.
How to automate user provisioning to Azure AD from SAP SuccessFactors.
New Power Automate triggers and actions in Teams, and other great features.
So let's get started.
With integration now available between Azure AD and SAP SuccessFactors, admins can now automate user provisioning to applications and resources to support HR and identity lifecycle scenarios, like hiring a new employee.
The ability to automate user provisioning ensures that new employees are up and running with all the necessary apps and resources from day one, while also reducing possible dependencies on IT help desk for onboarding and offboarding tasks. To learn more about how to provision worker data to Azure AD, check out the support documentation in the description after you're done watching this episode.
Managing and overseeing a team's administration can be a complex task, especially when supporting a large organization. That's why these two new Power Automate features in Teams should help streamline tasks for admins. The first of these updates is that you can now automate an app mention in a flow. For example, you can build a flow to automatically app mention a newly added team member. Then, when the new member joins, Power Automate sends a personalized message that app mentions and alerts them in a team.
There's also a new trigger available for Power Automate in Teams. With the For a Selected Message action trigger, users can now create customized actions directly from a message. For example, if a user built out a trigger to automatically create a task to Planner, this would help streamline and initiate critical business processes for organizations. And you'd be able to do all of this from a conversation. To get started, users can open the Power Automate app in Teams and start building out a flow with these two new actions.
With so many employees working remotely, it's important to ensure everyone's devices are protected. That's why a new experience in the Microsoft 365 Admin Center now makes it easier for small and medium-sized businesses to deploy a lightweight security baseline policy. This new policy applies to all Windows 10 devices that are enrolled in Microsoft Intune with a Microsoft 365 Business Premium subscription plan. To learn more about the update, we've added a blog post about it down below.
And now we're really excited for this next segment. For the first time since we started doing this show remotely, we're bringing back interviews.
And this month, we have Senior Product Marketing Manager Andrea Iowanu, who's here to chat with us about new features for Whiteboard in Teams and on the web. Andrea, thanks so much for joining us today.
Thanks so much for having me, Vivian.
To start things off, for our viewers who may not be familiar with Whiteboard, what is it and why is it so powerful for those of us working from home right now?
So Whiteboard is our freeform digital infinite canvas. So you can add as much content as you want, and the canvas is infinite, meaning that you can continue to add, it keeps going, you can zoom in, zoom out. You can also add text, sticky notes, and drag and drop functionality to the whiteboard. With us being in this remote and hybrid environment right now, it's even more important for all of our users to feel more inclusive in their meetings, especially when they're all virtual. So now that we've added these three new features, sticky note, text, and drag and drop functionality, everybody is able to feel like they can contribute to the board. They won't need a pen or a stylus or a touch screen. Simply, they can just start adding text or sticky notes onto the whiteboard to feel inclusive.
Yeah, that's just one of the things that's really difficult to replicate right now, just this whole notion of collaboration. Could you tell us about the new features now available in Whiteboard and where users can find them?
They're just simply on the toolbar when you open up Whiteboard. You'll see a sticky note, a T for a text, and then you can drag and drop anything that you add into the whiteboard. These features are super important because I think, Vivian, we've all been in meetings before where we're adding physical sticky notes to a board or to the wall and then moving those objects around to try to have our brainstorming and collaboration sessions. So now with Microsoft Whiteboard bringing this all virtually, it's very important for us to continue that collaboration in our new hybrid work environment.
So how can our users actually get started with these new features? And is there anything in particular you want to call out to our admins?
So with the new features, we've made this really simple for users. As long as they're deployed via Teams, you can just open up the share tray and start your whiteboard right away. We also have full functionality in Whiteboard in the web, as well as in our Windows 10 app. And we have support articles on our website, which you can find, which give a little bit more information to help you along that journey.
For our viewers, you can find the support page and the website that Andrea mentioned down in the description below, as well as additional resources to learn more about Whiteboard. Andrea, thanks so much for joining us today. We really appreciate it.
Thanks so much for having me, Vivian. Hope to see you in the office at some point.
You know, I actually love Whiteboard. I doodle with it all the time in my Teams chats.
Oh, that's nice. And this is such a great update. You can collaborate, move around the sticky notes. It's like working together in an office, but you're doing it virtually.
Yeah, that's honestly one of the things that I miss most about going in is just being able to collaborate with my team in person.
If your users are working on a Visio diagram in Teams, they can now add a diagram as a tab to the top of the channel or chat for quick and easy access. To add it, go to the diagram you want in Teams. Select the three dots and then select Make This a Tab. The diagram then appears at the top of your chat or channel. Although any Teams user can add a diagram as a tab, to make edits to the diagram itself, you must be a Visio Plan 1 or Plan 2 subscriber. To learn more about this update, we've added some additional reading in the description.
And that's a wrap on all the updates that we have for August.
To check out additional resources we called out in this episode, like the support pages for Whiteboard or how to provision user data to Azure AD, make sure to check out the description below.
We'd love to hear your feedback. Do you have any thoughts about the structure or content of this episode? Let us know in the comments below.
And if you like this episode, be sure to give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to get notified of future videos that come out on this channel.
Thank you so much for watching and we'll see you in September.
Bye. Bye.